Hi friends, I'm José Luis Mompell, and today we're gonna see 6 useful tips for bone harvesting. Let's go for it. Tip number one. The first tip that we want to share with you today is the location for bone harvesting. As you know, there are several areas in the oral cavity from where we can harvest bone. Either the chin, the ramus, or in our opinion, the best one, which is the retromolar area. For being more accurate, the external oblique line. And why is that area, in our opinion, the best one to harvest bone from? It is because we are very used to extracting wisdom tooth. Oral surgeons, periodontists are very used to removing wisdom tooth from that area. And we are very used to the post-op that we are going to find, which are limitation when opening the mouth, inflammation, and no pain. Yes, no pain. When we strut a wisdom tooth, when we go under a therapy of painkillers and antibiotics, our patients normally do not get infected and do not have pain. It's really well controlled with painkillers. So it's a quite well-known post-op for all of us. So retromolar area is, in our opinion, the safest and most predictable area for bone harvesting. Second tip that we want to share with you today is what kind of radiological aspirations we need for bone harvesting. Okay, this is absolutely mandatory to know that a CVCT, a CT scan, it's absolutely necessary to harvest the bone block. Why? Because nowadays there is no reason for harvesting bone with just a panoramic X-ray. Okay, we need to have a CVCT. We need a 3D image of the area where we want to harvest bone, because we need to know the relationship between the external part of the mandible and the location of the alveolar nerve, okay? So it's absolutely mandatory to have a CVCT.
The third tip we are going to see today is the approach to harvest a bone block. Which kind of approaches can we perform? We can perform mainly 2 approaches. The first one is the same one we are going to do when we are removing an impacted wisdom tooth. It's an intracircular incision, 1 vertical release incision medial to the first molar, and 1 vertical posterior incision up to the ramus. The same way that if we were going to remove a wisdom tooth. The second approach we can do to harvest a bone block is right on the oblique line from the mandible. What kind of advantages has the second approach? First thing, we are not going to have any recession in those tooth, and afterwards the suture is going to be really easy. Fourth tip, we can use burrs and chisels like we used to do years ago. We could also use a piezo device, or we could use the Microsoft kit for dentsply to harvest a bone block. With the piezo device, it's really safe. It's a little bit slower, and you have to be really careful because if the blade touches the retractor, it can break. The Microsaw is really fast. You can harvest a bone block in almost from 5 to 8 minutes, but you have to be really sure where the alveolar nerve is located. One advantage of the Microsaw is that it's a really small box, so it's very easy to take it with you if you work in other clinics. It's not heavy at all. One disadvantage of the piezo device is right the opposite. The piezo device is like a suitcase, so it can be a little bit more uncomfortable to travel with it.
The fifth tip that we want to share with you today is that no matter what kind of device you use for harvesting the bone block, either the Microsaw or a piezo device, you have to be absolutely sure that all your osteotomies, verticals and horizontal one, they cross each other. That's absolutely mandatory. Why? Because if they do not cross each other, you don't have that little cross, you will have some problems. You will struggle yourself when harvesting the bone. They will not pop out, okay? The bone will not come out easily. So when you are sure 100% your osteotomies are crossing each other, that at that moment, you can start like using your chisel to harvest the bone block. Know before that you make sure your osteotomies cross each other.
The sixth tip we are going to see today is where to harvest the particulate bone we are going to need. Why? Because we are performing Curie technique, split bone block technique, and we need that particulated bone to fill the gap in between the thin bone blade and the bone of the patient. Where are we going to harvest these particulated chips? It's important not to safe scrape the inside of the side where we have harvested the bone block. Why? First thing, because it's going to be more uncomfortable, more difficult to scrape a spongious bone, and second thing is that now we could hit the alveolar nerve. So where are we going to harvest this particular bone? We can scrape from the edges of the bone block harvesting site. And also the cortical bone has the highest quantity of BMPs type 2. It has the most osteoinductive power.
Well friends, we hope you have enjoyed this video. Please leave your comments down below. And as we always said, the scalpel in your hand and your prosthodontic outcome in your head.